to even get to Maradi, I had to travel to Niger Republic to even beg them. They're not bringing their money, it's their money, but I'm begging them to allow me access into Maradi.
Why is it so important to go to Maradi?
Okay, it's simple. Currently, Niger Republic is exporting through Benin Republic. All the countries that are landlocked in the Western West African region are exporting through Benin Republic, Togo, Ghana, Ivory Coast.
Not Nigeria.
Not Nigeria. Why are they not exporting through Nigeria? Oh, your roads are bad. So the railway takes care of that. Oh, customs are difficult. They will charge us things that are not what we are charged in Benin Republic. Immigration does not allow us. Even when we pass all these police checkpoints on the road, custom checkpoints on the road, immigration checkpoints on the road, then communities have their own checkpoints on the road. Armed robbers attack us on the road. So we prefer to go where it is safe and cheaper to do business. So all we're saying to you is, oh, okay. So we come to Maradi, we build offices, we build a warehouse. You put your thing in the warehouse, you deal with customs at Maradi, deal with immigration at Maradi, deal with police and whatever you need to check for the goods to go. Once we put the good on top the car, on top the wagon, straight to Lagos. When it gets to Lagos, straight to the ship, because the things you would have done in Lagos, we have done in Maradi. So it makes it cheaper and easier for them to do business. No community will stop the train and say, where are those things from Nigeria, or for instance, or where are those things from, say, Chad that want to use Lagos?
Right.
It's just once you finish at Maradi, you put it on the wagon, you appear at Lagos, you board the ship and off you go. Or if you're importing from outside the country and you want to go to, you are from Nigeria or Chad, as soon as you finish at the Lagos seaport, straight, the next place you see your goods is at Maradi. So what we're doing is to grow Nigerian business and Nigerian economy. Those people will come, let's assume the ship is not leaving that day, they will sleep in Lagos, so they pay for hotel, they buy food, they do business, so you're growing the economy. So what are people complaining about?
This is a very expensive project, though.
1.9 billion?
Yes.
How much is to Maradi? So you stop at Jibia. Maradi is just 20 kilometers. So Maradi won't be up to $200 million. So what's expensive about it?
The argument of those who are talking about it is that $200 million could have been used, for example,
to do what?
To complete the East-West Highway.
China is not lending you money for... Okay, not even China, it's ECA, that's European Union. They're not lending the money for road now. They would probably not lend you the money for road. But if you complete, if you took $200 million to complete whatever road you want to complete, and you lose the kind of business that would generate more than $200 million, which one would you prefer?
But on balance, don't you, as Honorable Minister, think that possibly the East-West Road also generates that kind of revenue because it's within the country?
What revenue does it generate?
If I understand the concept properly, the East-West Road kicks off in Lagos and goes all the way to...
Let's kick off from Lagos. It kicks off from Warri.
Fine.
Warri to Calabar.
Which is where we have all don't forget
that the one from... this place in Akwa Ibom to Calabar has not been constructed. In fact, they brought it into the cabinet. The minister was saying about 400 billion naira or so to construct it, but it's all bridges. But that's even not the issue. The issue is that as much as East-West Road is economically relevant to the country and to the South-South, it's also important to point out that after some years, maybe 10 years, it will break down.
Why do you say that?
Have you driven on it? It goes bad. The tonnage on the road is higher most times than the road. That the only saving grace for East-West Road will be if we construct the Lagos-Calabar Railway, which will be able to convey the volume of wet cargo that you have to carry on that basis.